And yet tonight, where you've had chances of our territory, what's your sort of summation at the end of it? Just let down by key moments at both ends of the pitch, I suppose.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think we did have chances. It felt like we could score at any moment. Frustrated with the first half because you felt for all our good play and chances we had, we should have scored. Second half, of course, we scored two. But I think the thing that cost us the game is how we defended the goals. Now, I don't think we're under huge pressure tonight. I don't think that our goal was felt at risk, but we conceded three goals. And the manner of those goals is hugely frustrating for us. Each one, I think we'll look back and sort of hang our heads, really, because we should have done better. And you score two away from home, you expect something from the match. You can't need to score four to win.
Does that leave you thinking about changes potentially ahead of Sunday in some areas?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, we'll look at it. I mean, I think we have players back and available, but are they 100% themselves? No. And I think that's the difficult position that I'm in, where I need them to enter the pitch feeling themselves, feeling really good. And so I picked the team that I went with tonight, and I believed in the team. And the team, I thought, performed well, but just not well enough in those key moments, as you say.
Thanks. Luke, and then to Jordan.
I take it you've seen the stuff about the VAR vote that's been instigated. How do you feel about that today when you haven't had a penalty in the first half?
Yeah, I was surprised because I was watching it back at the time trying to see what had happened and why Anthony had gone down, basically. I was like, well, there must be a reason. So first couple of views of it, I couldn't see. And then you could see the contact. You know, it's an absolute stonewall penalty. I don't know how VAR's not got involved in that. That's its job. I'm the same on VAR as where I've always been. I like the power being with the referee, even if they miss penalties like today. So for me, offsides, yes. But give more power back to the referees.
What's your message now, going into that final game against Brentford?
The message is we need to do everything we can to win. I learned from today. You know, today's sort of too similar to other away games where we left feeling frustrated with ourselves. We leave feeling that we're a better team. Not than our performance, because I think the performance showed we're a good team, but than the result. And we've got to deal with that for next year.
Thank you.
Okay, Jordan.
Was Lewis Hall positive for you tonight?
Yeah, I thought he was terrific today. The goal aside, the goal was an unbelievable finish from him from distance. He is capable of that, but his all-round performance, I thought he looked really good defensively, very good on the ball. For such a young player, he shows real maturity. So, yeah, delighted with how he's progressing.
In terms of the chances and in front of the goal that you've had, do you feel that's been a repeat in many away games this season? Are those chances but just lack of cutting
edge
on the road?
Yeah, I mean, possibly. I would say it's more the defensive side of the game that is different from the previous season. Last season we were great away from home defensively, a lot of clean sheets, maybe not true classic performances, but 1-0 wins. We've missed that this year. We haven't delivered anywhere near as many of those type of performances that you need on the road, and we have to look at why. We have to look at the personnel of the team. We have to look at the mentality of the group, because we should be delivering better than that.
Up to Lee Ryan and then down to George Coffin. Lee?
How do you see the situation now? Is it out of your hands, or do you still feel you've got a bit of a control in this?
Well, the control we've got is our performance and result against Brentford. In terms of what will happen regarding Europe, I think that's now out of our hands, and yeah, we have to accept that after today. It doesn't mean there's no hope. There's hope, and we'll give everything we can till the last minute of the season.
Tonight, and you couldn't handle that for 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, well, we did start with the swagger. I thought we started really well. I don't think we really lost that. Yes, the game was, both teams were in it. But I don't feel we were, as I say, for the away team under huge pressure. I felt we created the better chances. But yeah, the game got away from us in the key moments.
Thanks, Lee. George?
Does it kind of feel appropriate that an epic season should go right down to the wire? And what's the mood like in the dressing room? And presumably you've got your players to bounce back.
Yeah, I mean, this season, I've been saying for weeks, I think it will go to the end. And I didn't want to be the to create that by thinking that, but I just had a feeling that it was going to go to the end. Yeah, the feeling in the dressing room is one of frustration, I think, frustration at ourselves. And I hope the players use that to respond on Sunday.
Okay, go to Dominic, and then we'll finish with Mark and Scott.
Just on Kieran Trippier, was it always the plan to start him tonight and play him for as long as he did?
No, that was dictated to by Tino's injury. So Tino picked up an injury on Saturday to his ankle. So Kieran had to play when he's had limited training time. But like a number of players for us this season, he's put himself forward for the group. I think he's played well, but I think he was fatiguing in that moment, so we had to get him off.
Just on Tino and Callum Wilson as well, who missed the game, how close are they to Sunday's game?
Tino won't make Sunday. And we just now need to get him right for next year, next season. And yeah, Callum we anticipate will be fit.
Okay. Mark,
was Alex okay? He obviously said he really sort of why was he kind of touch and go, but
no, he was fine. He trained yesterday and was good to go.
Do you feel like he was quite sharp as he normally is? Because a couple of chances where he probably would have buried him.
Yeah, possibly. I think whenever you have an illness, you'll know it yourself. You don't feel probably 100% for a few days. But I don't think he'll have any excuses on his performance. He was, as I said, he trained yesterday and said he felt really good.
Thanks, Mark. Scott, to finish?
You kind of touched on it, Eddie, but we've sat in a number of kind of dressing rooms, press rooms rather, away from Bourne this season, and kind of said uncharacteristic defensive frailties, really, and that's been a big difference from last season. I mean, I know it's early for reflections, but in terms of the away campaign, that has kind of been the story of it, hasn't it? You've been in games, you've dominated a number of games, but
yeah.
Defensively it just hasn't been the same as
last season. Yeah, no, I'd agree with that. I think there's reasons for that. You look at our back four today, it's different to last year. I mean, obviously it's a different season. But you look at the players we've had injured that have been associated to that back four or back five, it's been a heavy toll for us. Now it's up to us to try and put together a back four, back five that can perform better than it has. And I think there has been spells where we've looked really good. So it's not all been bad, but overall, when you look back, that's been certainly something that's hampered our progress.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cheers.